35th chapter of the second book of Chronicles. Josiah kept the Passover to the Lord of Jerusalem. Passover lamb had been killed on the 14th day of the first month. He appointed the priests to their offices and encouraged them in the service of the house of the Lord. He said to the Levites who instructed Israel and were dedicated to the Lord, put the sacred ark in the house which Solomon, the son of David, king of Israel, built. It is not to be carried about on your shoulders. You are now to serve the Lord your God and his people Israel. Prepare yourselves by families according to your divisions, following the written instructions of David, king of Israel, and those of Solomon's son. Stand in the holy place as representatives of the family groups of the lay people. Your brothers, one division of Levites in each family group. Kill the Passover lamb and carry yourselves, and prepare for your brothers to fulfill the word of the Lord in all three places. Josiah contributed on behalf of all the lay people present 30,000 small livestock, that is young rams and goats, for the Passover, in addition to 3,000 bulls. All these were from the king's own resources. His officers contributed willingly for the people, the priests and the Levites. Hilkiah, Zechariah, Jehiel, the chief officers of the house of God, gave on behalf of the priests 2,600 small livestock for the Passover, in addition to the 300 bulls. Conaniah, Shemaiah, and Nathaniel, his brothers, Hashabiah, Jael, and Josaphat, the chiefs of the Levites, they gave, on behalf of the Levites for the Passover, 5,000 small livestock, in addition to 500 bulls. Well, when the service had been arranged, the priests stood in their places, and the Levites in their divisions, according to the king's command. The Levites killed the Passover victims, and the priests flung the blood against the altar, while the Levites flayed the animals. Then they removed the fat flesh, which they allocated to the people by groups of families for them to offer to the Lord, as prescribed in the book of Moses, and so the bulls. They cooked the Passover victims over the fire, according to custom, and boiled the holy offerings in pots, cauldrons, and pans, and served them quickly to all the people. After that, they made the necessary preparations for themselves and the priests, because the priests of Aaron's line were engaged till nightfall in offering whole offerings and the fat portions. So the Levites made the necessary preparations for themselves and for the priests. And the Asaphite singers were in their places, according to the rules laid down by David. The doorkeepers stood each at his gate. There was no need for them to leave their posts, because their kinsmen, the Levites, had made the preparations for him. In this manner, all the service of the Lord was arranged that day, to keep the Passover, and to offer whole offerings on the altar of the Lord, according to the command of King Josiah. The people of Israel who were present kept the Passover at that time, the pilgrim feast of unleavened bread, 7 days. No Passover like it had been kept in Israel since the days of the prophet Samuel. None of the kings had ever kept such a Passover as Josiah kept. But the priests and the Levites and all Judah and Israel were present, and the inhabitants of Jerusalem. But this Passover was kept in the 18th year of Josiah's reign. also with the morning of promise. They will receive the very life of God within them in the form of the Holy Spirit. I have told you all this to guard you against the breakdown of your faith. They will ban you from the synagogue. Indeed, the time is coming when anyone who kills you will suppose that he is serving God. They will do these things because they did not know either the Father or me. I told you all this so that when the time comes for it to happen, you may remember my warning. I did not tell you this at first because then I was with you, but now I am going away to him who sent to me. None of you asks me, where are you going? Yet you're plunged into grief at what I have told you. Nevertheless, I assure you that it is in your interest that I am leaving you. If I do not go, the Advocate will not come. Whereas if I go, I will send him to you. When he comes, he will prove the world wrong about sin, justice, and judgment. About sin, because they refuse to believe in me. About justice, because I go to the Father when I pass from your sight. About judgment, because the prince of this world stands condemned. There is much more that I could say to you, but the burden would be too great for you now. However, when the Spirit of truth comes, he will come. He will not speak on his own authority, but will speak only what he hears, and he will make known to you what is to come. He will glorify me, for he will take what is mine and make it known to you. All that the Father has is mine. That is why I said, he will take what is mine. third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Thank you.
Man was born in South Africa in 1927, studied at the South African College of Music, major of the Royal Academy of Music, and taught music at Hull and Birmingham universities. Us to defend through thy word. Praise is there, O God, that all the world send me